And now I've made Chris angry so he can kill me in Chambara.
Chambara.
We need to all have a different Chambara. You can say Chambara if you'd like.
Chambara.
Everybody, welcome to Game Devs Play Games. And
Chambara.
Okay, so we're playing
Chambara.
All right, there are four people in this room right now.
No!
Which we haven't done since Dokkapon Kingdom.
That's true.
Well, that's because everyone died from Dokkapon Kingdom.
Yes. So, because everyone died at Dokkapon Kingdom, now we have two new guests.
Woo!
Tony, introduce yourself.
Hey, I'm Tony Leva. What's up, guys?
Well, more importantly, why do you matter on this show right now?
Why do I matter? Because I'm a blast to play games with.
No, Tony, it's because you're starting a new show on our network.
I am starting a new show on your network. I am a sack of shit. Thank you, Chris.
That's actually what his show's gonna be called.
Yeah, you can actually go to the restroom, Tony. You don't have to hold that in.
Dude, I have a catheter in right now. I am good
but
go!
Okay, anyway.
That got weird fast. We also have with us...
me.
Danny.
My name is Danny.
Oh, no, I like May.
May. My name is May.
Danny is a Twitch streamer.
I do that.
You also have a YouTube channel. What's your Twitch name?
My Twitch name is Felix13, F-E-A-L-I-X-13.
And if you ever want to see any, like, crazy gameplay of using one of those, what, neural controllers?
It's an EEG headset, but it's made by Emotive.
Looks really cool.
But he controls the games with his brain. It's crazy.
Brain game.
Prank game. You're the worst.
No, I really am. You guys should have invited me.
Okay. Maybe we should just put it
So we're going to play Chambara.
Chambar.
No, I say Chambara.
No, you should.
I say Chambar.
Black team. Called it.
White team, I guess.
Black team.
Bam.
So boned.
Bitch, you're going down.
Because these
Chris,
guys...
Chris, you're going to die.
I'm so bad at this game, dude.
Okay, all right,
wait. I know where I am.
All right, so we're not
playing. Wait, I think Whitey just fell off and died.
My controller's so messed up.
We have 51 seconds.
Hold on. I am not controlling my character right now.
It turns out that I'm actually on the white team.
Oh, so I'm on the black
team. I'm on the white team as well.
Huh. And I'm on the black team. All right.
I think it's the color that you have to, I don't know, go down.
Okay, so...
Why do you have to lunge when you attack?
Oh, you don't.
There is a non-lunge button.
I died.
And every time you attack, if you notice, your stick, your kendo stick, I guess what it is, right? Oh, yeah, is that what it is?
Yeah, it's called a shinai.
Oh, very cool. See, I don't know things. Turns the color of the sky.
You're the color of the sky.
It is. Yes. Well, if I'm blue, man, that's kind of depressing.
So blue man.
The point of the game is basically to stealthily kill each other and hide in your color because you can't be seen.
Racism.
It's actually pretty clever. But as soon as you attack, you either end up in either, like, the opposite color zone, or you are blue and you can be seen.
And once you die... that's crazy.
And once you die, you turn into a pigeon.
A pigeon bird.
It's probably a dove, but...
You can't jump, right? Because I can't jump.
Yeah, it's X.
You can jump, it's X, yeah.
Oh, well, clearly I don't know shit. Damn it!
Learn how to X.
Hi, buddy!
I did well last time we played this, but...
Yeah, you say that now, but you're...
Yeah, actually, me and you, we rocked.
We rocked!
So how do you attack without...
Oh shit! No, I'm dead.
I'm dead, too.
Did I get you?
I gotcha!
Yeah, I think it's first to ten. There's little lock
feathers.
You can,
jump up really high and then lunge all the way up in the air and gain all of the distance.
Oh, no, it's A to jump. Who said it was X to jump? It's definitely A.
I don't know.
Oh, I play PS3. I'm
sorry. Oh, well, yeah, we're using various controllers, so...
Can't get me!
Yes, I can. The game says I can. I might not be capable of it, but I can.
I'm used to PS4 right now, but...
Your mom's PS4.
I'm just saying. Oh, that's my team.
Yeah, why you hit me, buddy?
Yeah, I love you.
You don't love me. You don't even love yourself.
I've been trying. I've been working on it, man. It's hard.
I threw away. I hate this game. This game's stupid.
Low bird.
Die!
Oh my god!
Come on!
Where
is everybody? There's the light. Damn it!
Double team!
Oh my god, this is bullshit.
Oh god. Nathan, I need your help.
Nope. Teamwork over.
We're doing so awful, Danny.
I have no kills.
I have zero kills, but our team has zero kills.
Oh, I hit B! That's B right... That's X! I hit X!
There is no stopping this blade.
Yeah, there is.
I am like Mr. Missing here.
Until you're dead.
Well, no, I mean like if you hit a wall, it stops.
With your body. Stop it with your
body. And what I like with this game too is that there's this one random blue patch where there is water dripping. I guess if you're in that area, you can be seen easier.
Oh.
Well, all right. So this candle is supposed to be about game design, not yelling, right?
Yeah. I mean, we have.
Come on.
Oh, you can hold the attack.
You can hold the attack.
Oh my gosh! You can just keep charging forward. Oh, that makes this game so much easier.
Oh, I finally done.
But yes, to answer your question, Danny, this is predominantly a design channel.
Oh, I finally killed somebody, guys. I am halfway not so useful.
What?
I don't
know
what that's
supposed
to be. You
became less useful when you... Someone?
Oh, I died. Yep. Man.
He was kind of right, I suppose.
I was totally right. I do not lie.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
I am the fucking knight.
And by that, I mean
the day, because I'm white.
Yeah, but say.
Yeah. Whoa.
Well, unless you're a white knight. You can be a white knight.
See, I held my part up.
I got one kill.
I got four. I tied Chris. Neo Tokyo, there is no other place.
Locked.
Yeah, go to the reservoir.
That might have been where we just
How
were.
Do we unlock that? Oh.
Lighting.
All right, let's do this.
All right, Chris, you're my friend now.
All right,
who went to the white?
I'm white, I guess.
Now I'm gonna lose.
Oh, that's interesting. Okay, so your color actually chooses what portion of the screen you are, which is a little counterintuitive, because generally these multiplayer games function on a like what player number you are. So like player one's always.
Guys, I've already gotten the same amount of kills I got last round.
Everyone hates you.
Good job.
Sorry for interrupting you, Chris. Continue.
So player one is usually what, like top left, upper left, and then player two is upper. Right and so on and so forth. This game doesn't behave that way, which actually design-wise is not necessarily the smartest because it becomes counterintuitive that to anyone that already has that expectation.
Yeah, because it's so ingrained in every other game that when they pick it up, they get confused for a while.
Right, exactly. Now, to people that aren't already familiar with games, I suppose it's irrelevant, but...
Yeah, that's fair.
Well, I mean, but then they'll play this game a lot and then go to another game and get confused.
Yeah, no, that's totally fair. Not to say that makes this a bad game, though.
It's terrible. This is the worst game I've ever played.
My only problem, I still don't understand how the blink function helps you.
Oh, okay, so blink, I totally forgot that was a thing, but blink literally its purpose is to prevent screen looking.
Oh, screen peeking, yeah.
Now, the reason it doesn't really work, though, is because you're also blind when it's happening, so it's very, very circumstantial. In a fast-paced game like this, I would argue that that's not
useful. I just
feel like
it's useful. I totally agree with you.
Hey,
now,
remember when you're
agreeing.
Now, it might be a little bit more useful if there were better hiding spots, but pretty much anywhere you can go in any of these maps, there's always going to be at least one angle in which your opponents can see you from.
I'm Zatuichi!
Which that itself, I would say, is actually good design because it keeps the players moving around very actively.
I'm using this as its own challenge because that's how I play games.
Oh, got me.
I actually have only closed my eyes and I'm only screen peeking.
That reminds me of another game called Screen Cheat, which actually...
I see you, Nathan. You're looking at me. I can use that. Get out of here.
Oh, shit.
You can't touch us.
Yes! Dang.
I killed somebody!
Double T.
I killed you!
You're so loud and unnecessary for life.
Man, that's what everyone says about me.
Yeah, but I literally can't see the game. No!
I'm glad.
No!
I'm glad I'm on your team, Danny.
Oh, God, I got a kill. I didn't die while I was blind until now.
Actually, Danny, not to break your heart, but I think I got
my heart already.
I think I got that kill.
You had me at hello. They don't have to do that. Sorry, guys. I misread the situation.
So, when I saw this game for the bit bad, I immediately fell in love.
Oh, yeah, dude, this game was sick.
Wow, that was awesome.
Doesn't it kind of have, like, a pseudo James Bond feel to it? Like,
it
old
does.
Bond?
Old Scott-style James Bond feel? A little bit.
I don't know.
Well, I'm talking about more GoldenEye. Like I said, I haven't really played anything beyond that because there's not really a point to play any of
that.
That's
what I meant when I said
that's a strange comparison, too, because... the gameplay is actually incredibly different other than the fact that we're in a first-person multiplayer arena setting.
Yeah, true. It just has, I don't know, for some reason when I was watching this, it just reminded me of, like,
You killed my friend!
I think it has everything to do with the monochromatic style of,
maybe that's what it is.
You know, two very contrasting colors. Because it's very, that's kind of typical of like, the James Bond intro cinematics, right? Like,
what if we
looking through the barrel of the gun kind of thing.
Yeah,
you know?
Exactly.
So I get where you're coming from. It actually does make sense.
Well, I think actually the thing that makes me think of those old games is spawn camping of all things.
Yeah.
Damn it. Because, like...
Well, it looked like...
Oh, we won?
Boom! Yeah, Danny!
Damn.
I told you I'd rock you guys.
I mean, all right, I did better this round. I got, I think, five kills that round.
Okay, let's play one more match, and then we'll call it here.
I want to play forever.
No, you don't.
I do.
No, you
I
don't.
I guess we'll just do...
Really
yeah, it's random. We played the other ones already.
So the only one we haven't done is me
with
me
Danny.
And Danny.
Come to the dark side.
Oh, you're on the dark side, okay.
White guys always.
Yep.
I mean,
we cleanse this purge! So,
Sean the
what really gets me about the game is...
We're black.
Oh, I'm white again.
Oh, wow.
Damn it.
It, switches, it literally switches you.
I had
you.
A streak going.
Here's the weird thing. It looks like it switches whatever color you are to the opposite color, because I definitely chose black.
Yeah. It definitely does that.
Maybe that's who you're choosing. Maybe you're choosing who you attack, because everything else doesn't make sense compared to other games you play.
True.
I suppose it could be a bug in the game. I mean, I don't know if this is the full release of the game. I don't know. Do you remember during BitBash, Nathan? By the way, the reason we're playing this game is because it's going to be part of our BitBash series, where we're just going to play a bunch of games that we played at BitBash.
BitBash was a blast.
Yeah, Tony was actually at BitBash.
Yes.
The only one that wasn't there was Danny.
Yeah, I wasn't there.
Obviously, some games you can't play.
I was too busy being a personality.
Need to talk That's about weird. Don't what is it? Don't talk and nobody dies, or don't move and nobody dies. What was the Oculus?
Oh, stop threatening me.
What was it?
It was something,
in the
it was something along those lines.
We were rocking it.
Yeah.
You know what else reminds me of GoldenEye? Sitting in the vents at the beginning of the game going, I want to get out of here. Damn.
It is the safest place, although I've noticed that,
Whoa!
Your enemies can spawn in the same points that you spawn from.
It just spawned me.
Yeah, because that happened last time. Oh, crap.
It's okay, Tony. I
love
you.
But... Thanks, it's buddy. It's crazy because design-wise, it's actually kind of smart, so that staying in the spawn points are not actually the smartest thing.
Well, it's not safe.
Except you can hide in your color in the spawn points, too.
Yeah, you can, but that's why it also randomizes which color you go to. At least, I assume that's the decision.
Don't assume you know things,
Chris. I know some things.
No,
I mean, I try at least, right?
So,
bam.
You try to assume
I don't know if you guys noticed, but...
You guy?
Yep, you heard me.
I'm the only guy.
Well,
here,
I'm a dude, man.
What? I am the ultimate master. There are many masters.
Who did I just kill?
Nobody. It wasn't me.
I was hoping it was Nathan because he was talking a lot smack, and I hate Nathan.
Yeah, it's pretty true.
Teamwork.
I think I'm destined not to win this game.
I don't know if you've noticed, but half this game, I've literally just been, whoa.
I'm just destined not to win.
I just hit somebody and flew back.
I landed on your head, Nathan.
That might have been it, because I
really
just
Is there a defense mechanic?
There is no defense mechanic.
Because when I was looking at the attack button, there's two different kinds of attack.
Yeah, you can sit still and attack.
Yeah, one is a quick attack and the other is a lunge.
That one, like, I
now,
just fly.
You can use the lunge to actually... shit. You can use the lunge to blast yourself into the sky.
Oh yeah, that's actually what I've been doing at this time and creating a diversion.
Nathan, look out behind you.
Yeah.
Damn.
I was expecting you to get
it. Chris.
I couldn't beat you.
We got this, Tony. We got this.
I think you got it.
So when you attack, your sword and your person becomes the color of the sky.
I am just
always, no matter what state.
Yeah, which is super
and,
cool.
And leaves you exposed. Cool. So this whole time, like literally if you watch my screen later, you'll notice I was just jumping in the air. And just like doing that, and be like, look at me, look at me. And then Danny would come up behind me and kill somebody.
Yeah.
It's great.
I kept hiding in the shadows, and then Nathan would run him past me, and I'd stay.
It's hilarious. Two kills.
So
I am so good.
Wait, what's the feather?
Did anybody else?
Let's just tell you when you earned your kill, probably during the. Or when you die or something.
Oh, yeah, because it's going through the replay.
Because it's going through the replay right now.
Oh, I see.
Oh,
this is the stupidest game.
That's actually pretty smart. So did anybody else win two matches? Anyone?
I won two matches.
I did.
Well, everyone's a winner but Tony.
I won zero. If you could see
somebody
my face
has
right
to be
now,
the loser.
I'd be crying.
Okay, well, that's it for this game. Are there any final thoughts from you guys?
I
have a lot of thoughts, but...
I mean,
let's hear them.
Yeah.
I'm going to let him
talk. Mine's only like 2 seconds. I think it's a fun game to just kind of knock out really quick. With a lot of these Bit Bash games, I think I'll be checking out today. It's kind of nice to have like a party, you know? Mm-hmm. You can just have someone like set this up if you want to make a game, a night of games, not a game of nights. That'd be kind of weird.
I don't know. It could be like a medieval theme.
Yeah, it would definitely be a cool game to start off with or to make it like an end game because I don't know. I like the stealth of it. It's a fun game.
So, one of my things is, this seems to be in a theme with many games that I've seen lately, where there have been too much gimmicky, random BS mechanics in games these days, and they're just going, let's take out mechanics. Let's just make it simplistic.
Oh, it's extremely simplistic. That's kind of why I like it.
But another thing about this game is, coming from a speedruns perspective, because I do a little bit of speedrunning, it has so many movement mechanics that I think the game is deeper than it first appears, because the longer you hold your lunge, the further you go to a point, and then the longer you've lunged, the more of your shinai stays blue.
Mm-hmm.
And so it takes longer to refresh, too. In addition, there was an overhang that I don't know if anyone else noticed that I think you could jump to.
Yeah,
and
I was trying half the game. I never got it.
Yeah, you could get an overview of the map then, and then you could actually talk to your ally about where people are and stuff, because you'd be looking down. And so that's interesting. The whole color mechanic is interesting because it's like a cel-shaded?
Yes, it's cel-shaded, and they're specifically, they put no outlines.
Yeah, so that you blend in.
Mm-hmm. It actually reminds me a lot of Samurai Jack.
Mm.
Because they intentionally did not.
Yeah.
I don't think I would call it cel-shaded. I'm not sure that's actually accurate. I think it's just...
maybe not.
Yeah. It literally is a game void of lighting...
effects.
Light effects.
Actually, no, that's almost not true, because one of the things that they did with the game is all the parts where the light would hit is white, and all the parts that it wouldn't is black.
That's true, but it's intentionally placed, whereas using lighting effects usually requires a light emitter,
mm-hmm.
and you bake the lighting into the environment and all that jazz.
I don't know if you noticed, but...
this game's name is Chimbert.
I don't know if you noticed, but right at the beginning, there weren't many deaths because everybody's like basically like
being very careful
about it.
Everyone who's playing.
As the game progresses, the kills get much more rapid, and I think one reason why is because when you kill somebody, blood from the color of the spatter from the color of the sky hits the wall.
Yeah.
So if you walk across it, you can be seen because of the blood from the wall.
Well, I think there's that. Also, the first game I played, and this is actually another interesting thing because I do a lot of tactical things in real life. I started out with someone I didn't know very well as a partner, me and Tony.
Yeah.
And then it was someone that I kind of knew. It was me and Chris, but at that point, people were paired with people they were really comfortable playing games with.
Mm-hmm.
And then I played with Nathan, who theorycrafts with me all the time about games.
Yeah.
And when that happened, we immediately started devising a strategy without talking.
Yeah. Wow, yeah, good point. Didn't even think about that.
And so the kills started going faster and faster because of the people we were playing with as well.
I would say with Chris, when we won that match, it was because whenever one of us failed, the other happened to be there to pick it up.
I was
I
actually
say that's so strategic as just.
I don't know if you noticed, but I was following you for a lot of it. And anytime you missed, I would follow it up and stab them before they got you.
Well, another thing is, something that people don't think about is, there is a subconscious strategizing. If you're just comfortable with someone, you'll end up complimenting.
I think, too, a little hidden depth to it is knowing when not to do the lunge.
Yes, without a doubt.
And I think, weirdly enough, that actually goes kind of along the lines of the true traditional samurai duel. Because in the true traditional samurai duel, there wasn't this huge fight that lasted 15 minutes. It was squaring off, looking at your opponent, gauging how they were going to strike, and then getting them first as quickly and as efficiently as possible.
Mm-hmm.
Usually there might have been a parry or two, and it was over.
Mm-hmm.
And that's exactly how this game feels. You're right. Miter movement's incredibly important.
Yeah. And so that's interesting to me. I also think that there's a little bit of frill stuff, like the blink mechanic. Also, like, they allow for someone, they're like, oh, if this person's just better, they can be on their own team. Which is a thing from old games again. Like, I don't know if you guys ever did this with GoldenEye 007, but you just put one person on a team because he's going to kill everyone.
Because he's playing Odd Job.
No, I never played Odd Job. I played with somebody.
Or you just played
I played 007. Boris
Benenoff. Oh, Boris, yeah, he had no special ability.
Exactly,
there.
Because I just killed everyone. So I didn't need special abilities. I didn't even get the golden guns or anything.
No auto-aim either, huh?
Oh, auto-aim is terrible. You can't headshoot.
Back in that day? I guess, yeah, you can't headshoot them.
It would auto-aim to their core.
But yeah. Anyway...
Yeah,
sorry.
To wrap things up...
About Chambar.
I do want to touch on one point, terrible. Nathan, before we end it, and it's that your point about the blood spatters causing the deaths to speed up, I think that's probably the absolute most intelligent thing that they implemented design-wise in this game, because that ensures that there's good gameplay flow in every single match.
It does also prevent the game it's a good game flow, it prevents it from going too long.
Yes.
Because at first you have a lot of patience, but as the game continues, you start having less patience. You just want the game to be over. You want to win.
Well, on a related note, the blood splatter has a couple things. Because if the other team is using it to try and hunt you down, you can actually set ambushes from someone you just killed. Because you could hit them, then run into your own color and wait,
and then
just staring
watch
at
for
it.
That spatter. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Cool. It's a pretty cool mechanic.
Cool.
Well, so that's Chambara.
Yeah.
Chambara
is free. We'll have a link in the description, so check it out. But
they're gonna keep working on it. I'm excited for it.
It's a good time.
This
Nathan hates
this one of two games that I was immediately drawn to when I saw it on a BitBash website.
Yeah, I think this might have been my favorite game from BitBash, to be totally honest.
Oh, that's fair. I would totally agree with you.
Cool. Well, thanks for watching, and stay tuned. We're gonna be doing more episodes from games that we played at BitBash.
Except
we're not doing every single game because not all of them are out or available yet. But as they come out, we'll probably add more to the playlist.
It upsets me.
I know.
So many games I want to play.
Yeah.
Downwell.
Designers.
Downwell.
Wait. Pot Kettle Black. I was so excited.
Anyway, we'll see you in the archives.
Bye, everybody.
I was about to say,
we did a BitBash.
Even a one-player game, I can just sit here and yell.
You know what else we did four-player at BitBash? Yojimbo.
Yeah, but we did Chambara four-player.
Yeah, you know what else we did four-player at BitBash?
Yeah, Yojimbo. Hey, here's the thing, Nathan. So far, we have one against one. Let's find out who has the Omnibus.